Just as I'm getting on here to talk to you guys about what happened in the stock market today, what's going on with AMC, I pull up Ortex and I see a 350% cost to borrow max. So let's talk about exactly what's going on, because those are numbers that we haven't seen in a very long time for AMC. And I think it's pretty clear to see, and you guys hopefully will get some value out of it. Nonetheless, let's get straight into this video with everything you guys need to know. So AMC stock itself down 1.62% in regular trading, and after hours down 1.64%. So all in all, down about 3.2% on the day with AMC. Ape, on the other hand, was down about 5.77% in after hours, seeing a move up of about 0.61%. AMC stock itself did not get that after hours boost. And really what is happening today is you did see that end of the day sell-off, which you did hit a newer low by the trading bell today, which was definitely not a good sign. There wasn't a lot that actually happened today. Right, this was big as far as the actual technical level of where we're currently at. We are now at $395 again on the S&P, broke clean under the $400 level today, and that's really where we started. Even in pre-market, most of the time we were above or around that $400 mark. Now that we're under that, it really sets a new tone for the markets. And today, really over the past couple of days, it's been hard to break out above VWAP. So VWAP is this yellow line you see right here. You touched it 1, 2, 3, a couple times in there, 4, 5, 6 times throughout the day on these rallies from the lows, and we simply just could not break out above VWAP. So that means that trading algorithms are really pushing down the stock market right now, and there's not enough buying activity to sustain after VWAP. Because what happens if you're thinking about the broad markets, and especially the indexes or individual stocks that control the indexes? What happens is the market makers will provide that liquidity, usually to the downside, right? That's why market makers are formed, like the Black Monday, Black Tuesday, when the stock market dropped like 20% in a single day. The market makers were a big reason why that happened. So now there's an emphasis on supporting the markets on the downside, and that's why you don't see those big days. So essentially what happens is the market makers will drive down a stock, or in this case, we're looking at the S&P 500 index fund. They'll drive it down to new lows on the day, and then hit that buy button and try to get the stock back up to at least VWAP. That is the volume weighted average price. So if market makers, you know, are buying stock on the lows and then selling it around VWAP, if you don't have additional buying pressure coming in outside of the market makers, well, it's like kinking a hose, right? Once you get close to VWAP, that kinks really tight. So the market makers, they're not hammering the buy button as much if there isn't good news or a reason to buy. So that's kind of what we've been seeing right now, is a lot of this negative sentiment, and there's not really a big reason for people to be buying stocks at the current moment. There was nothing newsworthy that came out today, nothing really that sparked a lot of conversations or headlines on something like CNBC. Nothing, you know, too crazy. You did get Fed Mester that sees benchmark rate above 4% and no cuts through 2023. So a little bit more of that guidance, and possibly that could help bring down the stock market a little bit more. But we're starting to come to terms with this new regime of the Fed and how that is affecting the markets. Now, on the other hand, with AMC, you are seeing a cost to borrow rate, or cost to borrow max, I should say, at 357.82%, a cost to borrow average at 38%, and a cost to borrow minimum at 4.33%. You have the short interest dollar amount sitting at $1.02 billion of short positions on AMC stock. Estimated short interest of free float sitting at 21.43%, and the free float out on loan at 37.7%. Shares out on loan 194 million. Days to cover sitting at 4.07. And as pretty much typically said, the share utilization is at 100%. Usually that usually it is, so there's not a big surprise there. Now, the cost to borrow max, usually not in the three-digit range. Usually, it's not above 100, 200, or especially not 300. So, is this a glitch? Well, absolutely not. What is going on is you've seen a lot of bleeding to the downside, and really take into consideration this whole market maker situation. And for context here, when you see the stock market go down in general, right? Look at the COVID crash. Look at what we just seen in May or June. There's not really any stocks that are up, right? That are at 52-week highs. Very far and few in between to get stocks like that. So on those green days where pretty much everything rallies, it's not because people are just buying everything again. It's because of the trading algorithm. So when you see the cost to borrow rate spiking like this, it either means one of two things, possibly both. That the trading algorithms are going to start helping the stock a little bit more, going to cause a little bit more of that green activity when you get bullishness in the markets, right? Kind of start to, you know, support the stock a little bit more. Or it's an indication of, hey guys, we're probably just going to see a lot of volatility, maybe for the next couple of days, couple of weeks, because the cost to borrow is paid usually on a monthly basis, right? It could be a yearly basis, but most of the time it's paid on a monthly basis because those are shorter term positions. But in the grand scope of things, if you're a short, you know, hedge fund, you take out a short position, you have that short position for a couple of days, couple of weeks, maybe a couple of months, right? So if you expected the stock to move big over the next couple of months, well, you would charge a higher cost to borrow rate. Or you can get into the nuances of there's not a lot of shares available. Maybe there's this situation with Ape and AMC and how potentially synthetic shares could play into that, and the demand for AMC could potentially rise. That's another theory, and that's only a theory because there's no proof of that, but that's really what is going on with AMC stock. You could boil it down to, you're probably going to see a lot of volatility, you're probably going to see a big move to the upside, or potentially the downside, right? Cost per max just spiking. It's volatility. We are in volatility. And especially if the Fed keeps hammering home this narrative, well, I would expect to see the red days very red and the green days very green. We've had a lot of red days in a row. So odds are we start to get some green days and AMC stock could well outperform the markets. That's more of a short-term trading outlook if you're someone that is not sticking around for the MOAS. So those are the big things that I really wanted to discuss with you guys. But let's go ahead and take a look at the option activity, because we did see more options placed today on AMC stock than what we are typically used to. So for the day, you are seeing 17 orders totaling $1.1 million, positive order value of 58%. This is over double the total dollars we've seen head into AMC options yesterday, only about $543,000. Worth of options that were purchased on AMC as of yesterday. So today was definitely an increase to that overall dollar amount that is heading into options, and that could be another slight indication of potentially a bounce here to come. And if we look at the economic data, things that are happening tomorrow especially, you do have the ISM manufacturing PMI for August. That is a measure of inflation for manufacturing, right, for producers. So that will be important because that inflation tends to lead into consumer inflation, which would be the CPI, consumer price index. So that will be very important tomorrow. You also have Fed Bostic that speaks at 3:30 p.m. That's also going to be the big thing. Now on Friday you have non-farm payrolls for August and the unemployment rate for August, government payrolls, average weekly hours, non-farm payrolls, factory orders. You have a lot of data coming out involving jobs and the job market that will be coming out on Friday. So you do have two very eventful days left of this week as far as economic data. And I think whatever happens by the end of the week will be very important to pay attention to, because after all, we did not hold up at 400. And that, in my opinion, was a big psychological level that I certainly want to pay very, very close attention to. Now, nonetheless, if we take a look at AMC stock and actually break down some technicals of what we are seeing, especially over the last couple of days, you could see the stock really fights around that 850 level. It's very hard, to stay around that, to be honest. If you guys look at what happened just today alone, the high was $9.28 per share. The low was $8.68 per share, but we ended up closing at $9.12. So we did see somewhat of a bounce back, you know, throughout the day today off of the low, and that was a very good sign. It looks like you hit that low for trading algorithms, and they provided some of that buying pressure, but it looks like that buying pressure continued throughout the day. So I think that is a very bullish thing, definitely worth noting here in this video. Now, if we do take a look at the next moving average, is the 100-day moving average at $10.19 per share. That's going to be a big level to the upside to break out above, considering how much AMC stock is still moving, even when APE is now in the equation, is very, very interesting. And I don't think it'll be too hard in the grand scope of things to break out above 10, since we have really come down and found this support, and you're just trading at those lows. Unless we see more fear come into the stock market, new information, a reason for people to freak out, well, that freak out could be close to a short-term end. Don't make any trades based off that. I'm not a financial advisor. These are not recommendations or anything else in between, but that's what the data looks like from at least the charts and how the stock is starting to bottom out. Now, the MACD is extremely bearish, and the RSI is also at 36.32. That is really really on the oversold side as well, so that also does help point to a potential bounce that is to come. So that is pretty much going to be all for this video. Hit that like button, subscribe to the channel if you guys want to come trade with me live in real time. Link down below in the description of this video. As well as that, if you guys want free stock with Webull, Moomoo, and Public, also available to you down below in the description of this video. Get yourself that free money. After all, it is free money. Thank you guys for watching, and I will see you in the next one.